When you see the price of pearls.
How could such cheap pearls be true? Why are cultured pearls so expensive?
Hello guys, I'm Lucia, the pearl consultant from Hangzhou, Sharan. So glad to be here to share you something about pearls. When we talk about pearls, price is always an important point and it has always been a very controversial topic. Actually, as long as they are not artificial, they are all authentic pearls. Before the pearl cultivation technologies matured, pearls were unique luxury items of the nobles. And nowadays, they are placed in museums or auction houses. And of course, the price is amazing. Most of the pearls that we are talking about nowadays, especially those used on the jewelry, they are cultured pearls. And of course, the quality decides the price. As you know, a good pearl is one of the thousand, but how to judge the quality? Let's begin our today's topic. Basically, the size of pearls is between 4 to 20 millimeters, and the shapes will be like rice, baroque, and round. The bigger and the rounder pearls are definitely more expensive. This is also one of the reasons why the round South Sea White pearl is at the top of the pearl contempt chain. Of course, the special shaped pearls, collectively referred to as baroque, are also very popular in market in recent years. Pearls are mainly with these colors as you can see here. And there's overtone on the surface of the high quality rounded pearls, and it makes the pearls looking charming. When the overtone appears on the baroque pearls, as you can see here, there will be rainbow-like luster, and we call it as orange, which makes the jewel amazing. The luster of pearls can be excellent, very good, good, fair, and poor. Among the pearls with excellent luster, some of them may even with mirror-like luster and with overtone. We call these pearls as aurora pearls, just as beautiful as the goddess of dawn in the myth. The surface or the skin of the pearl, generally speaking, if the flaws are invisible in social distance, then we can see the pearl is flawless. For more details, please see the picture. A good pearl looks like a smooth as a mirror. With the thicker nacre, the pearl will not lose the luster easily due to the abrasion. For example, Akoya pearls are generally with 0.6 mm nacres, and Tahitian pearls are with 0.8 to 2 mm nacres. And for South Sea pearls, they are even with 2 to 3 mm nacre. Everybody knows the Akoya pearls are very, very shiny. The luster will last easily. I think maybe this is the price of shiny. As for the traditional freshwater pearls, they are without any nucleus, so it's full of nacres from inside to outside. And the nucleated freshwater pearls, which is quite popular in recent years, and the Edison pearls, they are both with 2 to 3 millimeter nacres. I think it's probably one of the most headache things for the jewelry designers. As a natural gemstone, each pearl is unique. A good pearl is one of a thousand. Looking for a match is more like looking for someone who looks like you in a vast crowd. Well, it's time to say goodbye. Hope you can learn something from the video. And please remember the information we've shared. It will help you to define the pearl's value. If you like the video, please follow us and leave your comments. We will continue to bring you more interesting videos. See you next time. Bye-bye.